Okay, I'm Todd with QRS Music Technologies and Piano Nation Music Center. So what we're doing is here's a Yamaha Disklavier. This actually is a DGP one with all the Disklavier boxes and CD players and everything else. What we're gonna do is upgrade it with a QRS MIDI Upgrade kit, which looks like this. Comes in a box, shipped right to your house, store, whatever. Yeah, I'm just making it easier for everybody. So what happens here is we took the front big box off of the Disklavier, because you have to keep the box with the Disklavier with the MIDI input on it on the piano. It doesn't have to be seen, doesn't have to be heard, doesn't have to be anything, but it has to be somewhere, because that's where they connect their MIDI at. From the QRS, we have to go MIDI in, okay? So we put this box in between the beams so nobody sees it. It's out of sight, out of mind. The power is always on. If you have to reset it, you just touch the power and that's it. Okay, so we looked at all the cords, we took all the cords off, we're trying to assess where we're putting everything. This is Yamaha's power supply. This is now their box that was on the front. This is a CD player extra they had back in the day. We took that, we're gonna take that off, but I wanted to show you before we took it off. And then there's a speaker. You can have many different types of speakers, and with QRS Music, you can have Sonos or Crestron or AMX or Control 4, anything in your home that we can hook to and then enjoy speakers throughout your house while the piano is playing. Okay? So the first thing we do is locate where we're going to put our QRS processor, which looks like that. And get the processor ready by putting the antennas on RFB and RFW. That's Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Now the neat thing about these antennas, they use both of them. So two Wi-Fi, two Bluetooth, they interact with each other. So that's the first thing that we do. Let's put these on the end. We kind of measure up where we want the processor. Now I don't want it sitting here where everybody can see it in the room. So I will probably put this one right here. And always remember, getting a Wi-Fi signal out of the house, you want these antennas accessible to be pointed down so that, you know, you can catch a signal in the house. And the only thing you're really going to see maybe is these little antennas hanging down, but chances are you're not going to see anything. So we'll put it here. And how we do that is in the box you have a super magnet. So a QRS super magnet comes with two screws. We call it the dog bone because it kind of looks like a dog bone. And so I put this on here like this. And this other Velcro. This keeps the processor stuck to the magnet even if you're moving in a truck or, you know. So you just put those on there like that, and then we put the two screws, put the magnet here. The magnet is very strong. So it holds the processor there. Okay, that's what it's for. That way it's less evasive because we have only two little screws to put into the piano. Little hand screwdriver, putting in where you're at. Kind of measure it up in the middle of the beam. Take your processor. The only thing we're gonna be hooking up is a couple cords here, so you wanna at least be a little bit accessible. So I put the antennas in the middle of the process of the piano. Now, because this is a MIDI upgrade kit and we're putting it on the Yamaha, we have to hook the power up here and a MIDI cord here. So we're gonna go MIDI out of the processor to the MIDI in of the box. And we already have that cable plugged in already. The MIDI cable's already ready. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the MIDI cable right there. We'll route the wires after we plug everything in, okay? So this customer had a power supply already on the piano, which we'll plug into, and we'll just route the cables underneath the antenna, plug it in. So that's the power. This makes the piano 3 work. This will go plugged into the power strip. Right there, the speaker's already in the power strip, and the Yamaha's already in the power strip. And then this will just go on the wall and control all power, okay? Then, now we have that. This particular instrument was sold to a hospital for the Pianomation 3. And they don't want to have anything accessible that anybody can come and touch. So our little box called a PLX box is the front end box. And all these cables. And remember, all these cables are not used. Many different applications in an upgrade kit. So we're only going to use the cables we actually need to. So here is the PLX box. That's a start and stop button, and this is volume. So to be less invasive, we're going to put probably this here so the customer of the hospital knows where it's at. We can put it here, but that's not very accessible. This would be better here if we put it on the rim at a little angle. That way, if they use the remote control eye is right there. Start and stop is right here in volume, so you don't need to have your device to work it. So now that we've mounted the PLX box here, and normally that PLX box goes on the front of the piano, but in this case, for the hospital, we're putting it on solid. There's two cables that we definitely need in the PLX box, even though we can put five for recording and different things like that. On this particular instrument, we only need two. And so the mini USB cord goes in the back of the PLX box, right here, okay? And then you have the PLX cable. That's for volume control and all the different things. So that has a, on this end, it has a network, like a TV, I mean a telephone cable. You just plug that guy in like that somewhere. Okay, so those two cables we definitely need. This cable is for data. So if we have to update or anything, we need that cable in there. This one is for volume control and everything else, okay? This is for the remote control to work and the lights, so it tells us what it is. There's a blue side and a silver side. This is called the 6-pin cable. It's a flat cable, ribbon cable. And this goes in the PLX box right here. And you just kind of feel where it needs to go and then you push it. So now that we have our three cables plugged in, again, we'll route them later. You take that ribbon, the flat ribbon cable, and it goes on the end of the processor, blue side to the top. So if you're reading PLX the right way, just kind of feel where it goes and just push it in. I always crank it a little bit so it gives you a little extra room after you tighten it. USB cable goes into host, and then the PLX cable, that's called serial com cable, goes in the side here at the very end. Well, it goes in one way, top, and that's it, done. Okay, now that we have everything hooked up, we can wrap the cables up. And usually you're gonna be under your piano in your house, you're probably not gonna put it on its side, so you could plug it all in, see if it works, and everything's connected properly. And then, but right now we're gonna wrap it up because it'll be proper. And then we have to plug the speaker in. Okay, now that we have it all done, wrapped up, we're gonna set it down. PLX box is plugged in. Cords that we are using are plugged in. The antennas are down. The Yamaha box is still on here with the MIDI cable plugged in to the input. This is to the output. Power's plugged in, speaker's plugged in. So now we'll put it up and we'll turn it on. Okay, now we flip the piano over. It's on its legs. We put power on it. And now the first thing we do is go to settings. And then you'll see Wi-Fi. If you get into Wi-Fi, you look at all the Wi-Fis. This particular piano is 9903. It's asking for a password. The password is QRS MUSIC. QRS Music. That's so your neighbors don't see your Wi-Fi and connect and play your piano at midnight. So that's going to connect. And once we get a check mark on that, then we can go into the processor to set up the Wi-Fi. Now that we have a check mark, we go and touch our icon that you downloaded on the internet, QRS Finder app. So that's going to go in there and look for any kind of player piano processor. It's going to find ours. There it is. Now we're building cookies for the first time. It takes a couple more seconds than it does in your house. Just the first time. Loading, please wait. So now we're gonna get our splash screen, we call it, and you can touch anywhere on the outside of the splash screen or touch any of these buttons. It'll get us into the processor. So we just, let's touch here. And there's a house button. You touch the house button so that we're at the first page. Play piano, record, practice, system setup. First thing we're doing is we're gonna go system setup. Then we're gonna go to performance setup. And then what we need to do is routing and delay, because we're doing a Yamaha Disklavier. We have to go to MIDI options. So we need to turn on all the MIDI options. So right here, the apply volume curve to velocities has to be on. Per channel controller, we want to go number one and apply minimum velocities to green. That means we can now work all the solenoids of the Yamaha. You scroll down a little bit, you see 5-pin MIDI out. So we want to turn that on because we're going out of the QRS into the Disklavier. And the rest of the stuff, piano scan, we don't need that on. Bluetooth MIDI out, you can do that, but you really don't need that on, so we just turn it off and you're done. Now we hit the home button. We're just gonna make sure that everything works correctly. We go play piano. We select a song. And we just push play on one. Set it up yet, and it plays almost perfect. Okay, so now that we know that everything's connected correctly, I push stop, and then I will go into my system setup, and I'm going to go to network settings. This is really the first thing we do before we do any activations or anything. Wireless network. We're going to connect to client Wi-Fi. It's going to pull up the Wi-Fi's where you are at. Yeah, salon network. Our password. So you put your password in and you push connect. That's gonna spin around looking for the Wi-Fi for a second, and it's gonna shake hands with the Wi-Fi in the house. Once that's done, we can do a trial activation, and it accepts the trial activation because it hits our computers at QRS. Now we're connected. It tells us we're at negative 55 dBm. That's really good. If you have negative 70 or 80 or 90, the piano probably will not work on that Wi-Fi, and you might have to get alternative methods to connect to the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is essential for getting downloads and new music that we send out all the time. So now we're connected to the network. I can go to my system setup, clock setup, push clock, and then I wanna do the client time. So if you are Eastern time, where I'm at right now, that's good. You just make sure you're whatever time zone you are, and then push client time. Now that you're on the network, it knows to connect to the client time. Third step, system setup, trial activation right here. Dealer registration for dealers and everything else. For customer, you do your customer. So I'm just gonna put dealer in there right now. Piano Nation, contact me. And my phone number. What is my number? 888-8074266. Register and activate. Now that's sending a signal right to our computer system at QRS. Now it takes about a couple seconds, and then all the music will pop up. There it is. So if you see ABBA, Adele, stuff like that, Aerosmith, you know the music is released. Then you just go over here to Adele, push one of her albums, there's a couple of them there, and then push whatever, hello. Here's your volume, speaker volume, piano volume, or piano and speaker volume together. Hello. You can EQ the speakers here. Touching that. Playback options. You can push all. So it plays the whole album instead of just one song. You can shuffle play from there if you would like. I can turn the speakers down. I can turn the piano down. Up. And that's it. That's how easy a MIDI upgrade kit is to do. So give me a call. At QRS is 1-800-247-6557. or 888-80-PIANO.